Hi everyone, it's Dwayne, developer advocate at GitGuardian. This video is a high-level overview of how to go about remediating incidents, leveraging the GitGuardian internal monitoring platform. We'll take a look at some definitions, how to prioritize incidents, how to investigate those incidents, and finally, the steps to take to remediate any issues found. If you're watching this because you're in the middle of an incident, don't panic. We're all in this together. GitGuardian is here to help. You're not the first person to go through this, and you definitely won't be the last. The worst thing you could do right now is to revoke a secret without fully understanding how it's connected to the rest of your environment. It might not be entirely clear how things are connected from where you're sitting. The best thing to do is make a plan, communicate with your team, and carefully remove and replace the secrets after getting feedback from the developers involved. And that's what the rest of this video is really all about. So let's move on to some definitions. When we say incident, we're referring to hard-coded plain text secrets found in your perimeter. Your perimeter is made up of all the places where you store your source code. When we say secret, what we really are referring to are credentials such as API keys, username passwords, certificates, or entire types of files like ENV files or PIM files, which should never be checked into your source control systems. When we say occurrence, what we're referring to is the number of times the same secret is found within an incident. In this example, we see in this one incident, we have two occurrences of the same AWS key. The truth is there's no magic bullet or one right way to prioritize your incidents. However, we think that certain data points can help you triage incidents quickly and consistently. The GitGuardian internal monitoring platform makes it easy to see these stats very quickly, beginning with the age of the incident. We often find very recent incidents more likely contain valid secrets, which need to be dealt with most urgently. We can also check the validity of some kinds of secrets, such as AWS keys, to see if they still work or if they've already been revoked. We show you the number and location of occurrences. More occurrences don't necessarily mean higher priority, but it's good to know what you're dealing with and how many places you could potentially be affecting by rotating your credentials. If known, you can see the severity of the incident. This can be set by your team to various levels of severity to help you triage when you're dealing with a large number of incidents at once. Finally, with tagging, we can quickly show you information about the secrets in question, such as if it's a regression of a once resolved issue that's showing up again, if it's a test file or a sensitive file, if it's been exposed publicly, or if it was discovered from an historical scan. Let's see what this looks like inside the GitGuardian internal monitoring platform dashboard. Here we are inside the perimeter view, and I can see, yes, I do have some open incidents. Clicking on the incidents in the upper left-hand sidebar brings us to the incidents view. From here, we can quickly see the date of the incident, the secret involved, the severity. In this case, it's unknown, but we could easily set that to any status as needed. We can see who committed that secret and where it was committed. And here are the tags. These example secrets have been exposed publicly, but don't worry, they're just example credentials. Hovering over the magnifying glass icons gives you a quick view of the secret in the context of the surrounding code. Now that you've prioritized your incidents and know what order to tackle them in, the next thing to do is to investigate those incidents. Some of these data points might look familiar, as much of it crosses over from a prioritization process. But it's important to think about all of these items while you're investigating each incident. We suggest you identify what type of secret you're dealing with, the validity and presence of that secret. By presence, we mean, does it still appear in your Git history? Exposure, is the affected repository public or is it confined to your internal systems? Is this a recent secret or is this from a long time ago? How many occurrences are there? And finally, is this in a testing directory? If it is, it's most likely that it's an invalid test credential only. In the GitGuardian dashboard, if you click on any of the secrets, it opens a secret incidents view. In this example, we see two occurrences. Here you can quickly see the date when it was added, who committed it, where it was committed, including the commit SHA. Both of these are visible in my Git history. And you can see the secret itself down below within the context of the surrounding code. Now that you've investigated the incident and feel confident you understand the situation, including what systems might be affected, it's time to start the final remediation process. Now that you've investigated the incident and feel confident you understand the situation, including what systems might be affected, it's time to start the final remediation process. The first step is collecting developer feedback. Sometimes you might find that a secret was a test secret and the developer can close that incident without any further issue. Understanding how the secret got into your code is an important part of improving your overall security. Once you've gotten that feedback, you can make your final review with your teammates to make sure that everyone is fully aware of the potential impact of rotating that secret. Now, you're finally ready to actually rotate their credential, revoke, and replacing them. Sometimes, you'll want to completely remove any trace from your Git history. That's a good conversation to have with your security teams. And finally, we highly recommend reviewing the access logs of the individual systems where that secret was associated and any connected servers. Let's take a look at how GitGuardian can help with the first step in this process, gathering developer feedback. From inside the dashboard secret incident view, you can turn on incident sharing for the developer in the right-hand menu. Once activated, you can give them the option to only give feedback, or you can give them the option to resolve or ignore the incident, in the cases where the secret has already been invalidated or it was just a test credential. Just copy-paste the link into your preferred ticketing system, an email or Slack message, and you're on your way to closing your incidents in a consistent way. Thanks for watching. I hope this was helpful. Remember, we're all in this together. GitGuardian is here to help you prioritize, investigate, and finally remediate your incidents involving your secrets.